Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.
Greetings and welcome to this month's episode of Beyond Breast Cancer. My name is Michele Reinert and I'm the Executive Director at Breast Cancer Support Services of Berks County. Today our topic is all about volunteerism. To my left, I am joined by Vanessa Shurley, our social media and marketing coordinator. And next to Vanessa is Leslie Fessler. She is a co-chair of our community awareness committee and also our volunteer coordinator. So she plays a very integral role in today's topic, and we're thrilled to have her here. Thank you for joining us. Thanks. So Vanessa, I guess the first thing we'll start with, we all kind of came to the organization, some in similar or different ways, and a lot of it revolves around volunteerism. So I'm just going to ask you both to share kind of a little bit of your story with us of how you came to BCSS and your role in volunteering, among other things there.
Okay. So for me personally, if this is your first time watching this show, so you may not know my story. I was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer in 2016. My first introduction to BCSS was through a comfort bag and their newly diagnosed program. And I just fell in love with the mission. So about a year into my breast cancer journey, I began volunteering. I facilitated the newly diagnosed program, which was one of my which was one of the first programs I attended as well, and just really got involved as far as the committee for the fashion show and the Young Survivor group. I still facilitate that and now Medivivor, but through that progression, I also became a staff member. So I guess you could say I've gone full circle from you know, receiving services to volunteering and now working there.
We are very lucky to have you. Thank you. So, Leslie, do you want to share your story with us?
Sure. I was diagnosed in 2014 with stage 4 metastatic breast cancer as well. And I was given the comfort bag at one of my very first appointments with my doctor. And in that bag, they had many things that were very useful. And the one thing was inviting me to a newly diagnosed program, which I had found very, very helpful, very helpful. And the people that I've met there are more like family now than just another survivor. Right. So we're all sisters now.
Yeah, I think after you come in for your first program, it starts to feel like home. Mm-hmm. And then it's what you're getting from it. But I think the most amazing thing that I see is the ladies then giving back and wanting to help that next group of ladies coming through. Because it's one of the first questions, like with the pandemic, I started 2 weeks before life as we know it shut down. So I am just now 18 months in meeting some of our survivors for the first time. And often it's like, so, you know, how did you wind up here? When were you diagnosed? Which always gives me a chance to say, for me personally, I am not a breast cancer survivor and there's no breast cancer in my family. However, I'm an only child who had both parents being treated for different types of cancer at the same time over the course of 2 years. And there was no other group like this for thyroid cancer or lung cancer or aggressive lymphoma. So you're like, what do I do? How do I make these decisions? Am I making the right decisions? And just the support as the family member and the caregiver, because what the survivor is experiencing is different than what your spouses and your children are experiencing. So I think that's the most important part about our group. And then if it wouldn't be for the well over 100 volunteers that support us on an annual basis, we're a very small local nonprofit, two full-time, two part-time staff, and we raise 100% of our budget every year. So if it would not be for these individuals that support us in volunteering, we wouldn't be able to do what we do. And in addition to that, everything that we provide is offered at no charge. So every workshop, program, service, resource, you know, we're doing all of that by raising the funds. So let's get into a little bit about volunteers and how important they are to our organization.
So, definition of a volunteer. Is a person who freely offers to take part in an enterprise or undertake a task, or a person who does something by free choice usually with no payment expected or given.
So I think what was interesting, like we survey for programs all the time. Mm-hmm. And what we've started to do in the last year, we've had the ability to look at some different things and some things we weren't surveying. So Vanessa, in her new role, has made it a point to really seek out volunteers and get their feedback on their experience. So the list she's going to share with you, I think, will be the responses that those individuals have given to her as far as what it means to them to volunteer for us.
So some of the responses we've got for what it means to volunteer at BCSS is satisfaction, accomplishment, a sense of community, friendship, survivorship, which also leads into sisterhood, like Leslie said, teamwork, education. Our volunteers, as well as the ladies that walk through the door, learn so much just listening to other survivors talk. New partnerships, support, togetherness, a sense of purpose, and fun, because I mean, I think we're a pretty fun crowd, and we're always laughing as we, you know, we get the job done, but we enjoy doing it.
And that truly is the best medicine, the laughter, the humor, the smiles that we can bring to each other. But let's take a step back, so to newly diagnosed, because I know, Leslie, you have a very dear friend that you connected with, and you continue to volunteer together, and it's amazing to watch the journey. If you can share a little bit about that with us.
Yeah, one of the newly diagnosed programs, we kind of were maybe a month apart, and the journey just, we were confident in each other and just would cheer each other on, you know, to get through, you know, what we were going through. And sometimes you didn't want to tell family everything you were going through. So it was good to catch up with somebody else that was going through the same things you were. And we just really connected, and we are like best friends now.
And you can see them both tomorrow at the Fall Fest on Penn Avenue, which we'll catch up with in a little bit. But I think, and Vanessa, for you, you know, now as a staff member who is also certified by the state to facilitate two of our programs, I'd like you to talk a little bit more about YSC and MediViver.
So YSC is Young Survival Coalition. That is for women diagnosed under the age of 45. And really they focus on things that don't necessarily get talked about, like fertility, dating after cancer, things like that. Because there's still that stigma a little bit of breast cancer being something that happens to you when you're older, and that's not the case. There is a lot more cases of younger women. So it really is focused on those types of things that younger women may be dealing with. So I do facilitate that program. I'm also a state leader in Pennsylvania for Young Survivor Coalition, so I have lots of state resources, even if you have somebody, a family or friend somewhere else in Pennsylvania, you know, we still have that connection. And then MediViver, we began offering during the pandemic, a MediViver support group. MediViver is a national organization as well that focuses solely on stage four breast cancer. So that was something nice to begin doing during the pandemic, is really addressing that as well, because there are a lot of different things that need to be focused on, you know, sensitive subjects like end of life and financial planning and stuff like that. So it's been great that we've been able to offer that as well.
Yeah. They think, too, when you think about the fact, you know, you look at Berks County and, you know, we have roughly 400,000 people in the county, but every year there are over 300 women that get diagnosed with breast cancer. And it can be stage zero to stage four, the triple negatives, the positives, the metastatic. There are so many different various things that people face. So when you come to an organization where there are women who come to programs that are newly diagnosed, we have ladies that have 20, 25, 30 years in their survivorship at this point that are still coming to programs because they're looking to take that next person under their wing. And it's the physical, emotional, mental connection. Like it reaches all of those, which is amazing to kind of sit back and watch that happen. And it's like very organic. but also, you know, they become our facilitators and our trainers for the next level of volunteers. So having said that, why don't we talk about all the different ways that you can volunteer at BCSS?
Can I read through some of these?
Okay. you can make different community connections. You can volunteer at special events or fundraisers. You can sit on a committee, volunteer at a tabling event, be a part of our speakers bureau, share your knowledge as a program presenter, become a program facilitator, or you can assist with different administrative tasks. And they do like the mailings, the comfort bag prep, and delivering them to the hospitals, office decorating for programs, set up, and to seek monetary and any other kind of donation. Mm-hmm.
So just to dig a little bit further into some of those, so for example, sharing your knowledge as a program presenter. If you have a skill set or you your normal 9-to-5 job, maybe you're a counselor or maybe you work in the financial field, anything that really could be a program, or we have program ideas as well, that you will be able to present something. So we're always looking for presenters, and we are planning out our 2022 year for mm-hmm. programs. So if that's something that you feel you have a skill set to share, definitely get in touch with us. But also program facilitators, those are the ones that help run the programs and kind of host those. And like this weekend, we have the tabling event. Mm-hmm. So there's so many different things that you know, you can bring to the table.
Yeah, and I think as far as program facilitator, people always get a like, oh, what does that entail? What does that look like? It's really not scary at all. And we have an entire training program for our volunteers that we go through. And we are now equipped to offer that either in person or virtually. So if you would have an interest in being trained to be a program facilitator, you can reach out to Vanessa or I. We'd be happy to talk to you about that and provide the training. And if you are a survivor, there are opportunities for you to assist as well. We do have a connect with a survivor. So mm-hmm. it's a phone line 7 days a week, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. So when people call in and they're experiencing something or have having difficulties with something, we'll connect them with another survivor that we can talk to. And the flip side to that is the email a survivor option. So if you are a survivor and you would be comfortable with people reaching out to you via email rather than the phone calls, you can join as a volunteer in that way as well. And we're always taking more survivors to add to those lists. Mm-hmm. We have noticed that, unfortunately, during the pandemic, you know, COVID had a lot of people going to the front line, to the emergency mm-hmm. rooms. It shut down some of the other areas. And there was a time where screenings were put on hold, mammograms were put on hold. But in addition to that, I think the fear of the unknown to those that are already immunocompromised were kind of pushing back or putting off those annual screenings. And we are seeing a little bit of an uptick now in the cases of the newly diagnosed. So there are a ton of opportunities out there. When we talk about the committees, that's new for us. That was new in 2020. We now have a fund development and marketing committee. We have a finance committee. We have a community awareness committee. So all of those different things, and there are seats available on each. It's a time commitment of, you know, 2 to 3 hours per month. One of those hours is a meeting. The other 1 or 2 hours are typically coming to something like the Fall Fest on Penn Avenue and working an hour or two at the table and sharing our mission and our story with those people that attend those events. I liken it to, no matter what your skill set is or what your passion is, we do have something for everyone to come definitely. In. And we are a family. You become part of the team mm-hmm. when you get connected to us in that way. So. BCSSBerks.org. If you have any interest, you can find information on our website. You'll also find contact information for Vanessa and myself. Please shoot us a message, give us a call, and we are happy to talk to you about all of the opportunities that exist.
And there are opportunities, whether you are an individual, small business, corporate, sororities. We've partnered with Zeta Tau Alpha
from Kutztown.
Fraternity, Rotary clubs, just general clubs and groups. Our 5K this past weekend, we had some Girl Scouts there. We had some employees from Mid-Penn Bank. So it's really you by yourself or with a crowd, it's more the merrier.
You know, the 5K was great because we had Mid-Penn, Discovery Federal Credit Union, Alcon, and again, their team members are like family. So they kind of kicked off the race for us with the cheering and the pom-poms, and even the guys picked up the pink and purple pom-poms and sent, you know, over 250 runners and walkers on their way. And then as far as sororities, as you said, so Zeta Tau Alpha, the branch at Kutztown University, they have 42 girls and they all went through the virtual training program. And then throughout the course of the year, there's different members of that sorority. So there was a group at the 5K, there's a group coming to the fashion show. We are talking about programs for 2022. We'd like to partner with them to do like a maybe a once a month story time for the children of survivors and things like that. So again, bring yourself, but bring your ideas because we are brainstorming all the time for different things that we can do. Again, not to just support the survivor, but the family and the caregivers as well.
So go ahead. Michele did mention, but if you are interested in volunteering, you can visit our website, bcssberks.org. You can click the contact us, and then there is a link on the right-hand side under volunteer, and you would just fill out the volunteer application. It's all online, and then I'll receive that and get in contact with you. Or you can email me directly at vanessa@bcssberks.org. And another option that's not on here, but we do have a Facebook page, so definitely check out Breast Cancer Support Services on Facebook, and you can DM me on there or any of the, we do float out occasional posts for volunteering. You can always comment on those and we'll get in contact with you.
Definitely. All right, so a lot of talk about volunteerism, but do you think we can spend maybe just a couple minutes because the 5K that we hosted this past Sunday, so at Grings Mill, Berks County Parks and Rec, Pretzel City Sports hosted that with us. It was a beautiful day. So we should throw a shout out to Mother Nature too, because that was something to talk about. But it was the best event that we have ever had. And the thing about it is that it is done in memory of Holly Lamont. And she was, I mean, if you want to talk a little bit about her background.
So Holly, I don't remember when she was diagnosed, but she started the 5K with Elizabeth Keller, who is a social worker at Tower Health. And unfortunately, she passed a few months after the first 5K. But the family has continued the 5K in her memory since then. And this year was the biggest one we've had since we had 250 pre-registered runners, which is the most we've ever had in general. And to have that many pre-registered is crazy.
It
so
is.
That event continues to grow. And it is such a great time because it is a family-friendly event. There's kids stations, there's raffles, walkers, runners. I think the walkers outnumber the runners for sure.
Definitely, most definitely.
But it really is a great time and a great community way to spend the day with your family, really.
Yeah, and I think too, because Holly's children, you know, nieces and nephews were a large part of the rock painting and the kids zone. The sorority did the face painting. We had Mid-Penn Bank doing the temporary tattoos. But again, I think Greg said it best, and he was a good sport about interviewing with the Eagle and WFMZ. But I think it's beyond what Holly would have expected, and this is truly her legacy at this point. So looking forward to 2022. If you missed it, you definitely missed a good time. Right now we're tentatively looking, it will be Sunday, September 11th of 2022, and our goal for next year is to try to hit 350 runners. And I say that because we did raise over $21,000 at that event, and every penny that was raised comes right back to BCSS, and it stays here in Berks County supporting those survivors. So it's a local event supporting our friends and neighbors and our community as a whole, which is fabulous. But with that, we can talk about some of our other upcoming fundraisers.
Okay. We have the Boscov's Friends Helping Friends, Wednesday, October 20th from 8 to 11.
Yep, and if you are interested, we do have passes at the store. So you pay $5 for your pass. That gets you your percentage off at the store. And then all of those funds raised stay with us. And you can use that pass at any of the local Boscov stores. So if those shoes you really wanted aren't available at Boscov's North, head over to the other one. You can use your coupon there. Can you tell I've done this before? But yeah, so we would like to also thank Boscov's for doing that, because that is open to every nonprofit organization in Berks County. And I think it's awesome that they continue to support so many of us in that way. All right, Vanessa, here's a big one.
All right, here's our big event, our signature event, the Pink Passion for Fashion, which is Sunday, October 3rd, begins at 11 a.m. We do still have some sponsorship and in-kind donor opportunities available, and you can get your tickets. There are a couple options. You can call the office to get your tickets. They are $75 a ticket. Additionally, you can check out our Facebook page or our website. The Facebook page does have an event on there with all the links that you would need to purchase your ticket. Our website has the exact same thing, but it will be emceed by Brittany Sweeney of PBS 39. Our models are local breast cancer survivors, and we do have two shining stars in the oncology field locally that were nominated by the survivors. Mm-hmm. We've reached out to all the survivors that we could, and they were two of them that were picked to be our shining stars. So that'll be exciting.
Yeah, absolutely.
But yeah, so if you're not doing anything October 3rd, definitely check out our website or Facebook for some more information and get your tickets to the fashion show.
All right, so let's look at our upcoming events. So some places that you can stop by, visit us, gather some information about our organization, but more importantly, have some conversations with our staff and our volunteers. So again, as we've mentioned, this Saturday, we will be participating in the Fall Fest. West Reading will be right out front of Chef Allen, so you know where to find us. That's 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Then on Sunday, you can find us in City Park for the Berks Cultural Diversity Festival. We will be there from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. The following weekend,
We have Guts and Glory, which is at Willow Glen in Sinking Spring. That's Saturday, September 25th, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. And then I know Michelle's looking forward to
it. This is my favorite, yes.
The Classic Harley Davidson's annual poker run is Sunday, September 26th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
We do need to note a couple extra details on that one, because we did partner with them for the first time last year and had so much fun that it was like, all right, can we do this annually? So this year, registration will be at the Harley-Davidson deal, a Classic Harley-Davidson in Leesport, and they will be given the information for their three stops on the poker run at that point. But the after party this year will be held at the Reading Liederkranz, kind of as a kickoff to Oktoberfest. That will be from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. And I will say, this goes beyond just motorcycles. Last year, we had cars, we had pickup trucks. I think our best decorated vehicle was the Dodge Ram.
Yep.
That had everything breast cancer you can imagine, from the front to the back, one side to the other. But again, it's just a super fun afternoon, you know, and it's hard to not have a good time. So the actual name of the event, which we thought was great, was Woobies, Boobies, and Beaners, Wieners. So this will be the second year for the event. So if you don't have anything planned Saturday, September 26th, please check that out. Get registered. Come and register the day of, because it is very much a full day of fun. Okay.
All right, and then to wrap it up again, I know we've talked about it a couple times, but if you are interested in volunteering, and again, that is such a wide variety of opportunities as far as presenting or helping in the office, helping at an event, please get in contact with us. You can do so on our website, bcssberks.org. You're going to hit the contact us in the top right and then click the link for volunteer application, and you'll fill that out and I'll get that. You can contact me directly at Vanessa@bcssberks.org, or again, not listed as our Facebook page. We do post on there about volunteer opportunities, or you can DM us there directly and we will get you signed up for something.
Okay. And we would be remiss if we didn't squeeze in at the end the different ways that you can provide a donation to support BCSS. So again, visit our website at bcssberks.org. You will see an opportunity to donate. You also can do it through our Facebook page. If you want to do a Facebook fundraiser, we can help you get that set up as well. And to make it super simple, you can also text BCSS to 44321. So we thank you for your time. Thank you, ladies, for joining me today. Right. Have a wonderful day, and we look forward to seeing you for the next episode of Beyond Breast Cancer. Thank you.
Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.